Hardest damn thing is to admit something to yourself and to others, and when you do that, it's kind of hard to go back into a story, especially when you put things down on another recorder. Avery John C., Roseville, California. Yes, 12:37 p.m. It's the 24th of October, Saturday. It gets me, the PTSD, the depression, anxiety, grief, everything at the same time. Turns me into a damn emotional cannoli. I don't know what the hell I'm feeling anymore. Watching a movie called Rambo, The Last Stand. So I was trying to explain all about 25 minutes on a damn recorder. Is the things that I've gone through, but also what I've seen of my own brother, who has gone through the same thing before he died. Sharing memories about that one. I'm seeing when I'm watching the movie Rambo, everything on his face, everything in my face, and my brother's face. I'm not a war veteran. My brother was a war veteran. Hell, if he would see the face when I was saying, he would identify. Because he'd been through the same damn thing, and I saw the same face on him. And he tried to keep his pain hidden like crazy, but I'd seen it from time to time. My brother and I had grown up, carefree kids, goes in the military, and everything goes wacko. No, everything changes for him, because things he went through, he couldn't even talk to me about because the PTSD was that bad, not to mention national security. But it took him decades to tell me about the Beirut bombing situation that he was in. He wasn't a Marine, he was a United States Navy SEAL. Came back from an op. Rescuing people and waiting for extraction, and the terrorists hit the embassy in Lebanon, Beirut, 1983. Part of his life even changed even worse during that time. He was already going through combat situations anyway prior to that, so he had learned techniques and how to deal with it. The only thing is, he also dealt with other issues that made him turn to drugs and alcohol for coping at times. He goes into the Navy. First time he's come back on leave from a major mission, and he's a different person altogether. My mother, who raised him out of the womb, knew everything about my brother and knew he was a different man altogether and wanted him to talk about it to someone. My brother had issues growing up as a kid, 8 years difference, older than me. And already he had mental health issues. But she realized he needed help, and when he sought the help he needed, told him to compartmentalize it. And he did, shoved it all the way down. Tried to bring back his old personality. But it wasn't all that easy, because he had to keep that steely attitude of his. Now, at home he was trying to be jovial enough. I knew that my brother was changed a hell of a lot, and I couldn't even deal with it or understood it as a kid. Still didn't. These days, I know more about it. And more accepting and more forgiving about it. My brother's been dead over 2 years, and I was in Chicago, he was still back alive. Even with all his damn crap he had to go through in his nightmares. Can't break back to life from ashes. At one point, when he already had his PTSD being treated or being taken care of, I'd see flashbacks, I'd see any anger. If he really wasn't talking to people about it to get a handle on the damn thing, he'd struggle with it himself. And being a recovering alcoholic, he was since 85, and away from the drugs, he really had to stay away from his stuff. And he worked on it. Clean and sober. A lot of help with the people who he confided into, mostly veterans. Veterans have been in combat, so he can talk to them more and more about what was going on in his head and his heart and the memories that were driving him insane. Dave and I watched the Bambo movies when they were out. My brother was partially in, partially out, then totally out, and then we're watching it. Sometimes I'd see the flashes. I didn't realize what the hell was going on, or I'd see the tension in his face or tension in his grips or something. Something about him changed. You'd see war films. Combat sometimes would or not affect him one way or another. We saw Saving Private Ryan when it was out in the theaters and it broke him down. It broke him down. And he had a hard time dealing with it. Even talking about it. Even his own combat experiences. He saw it. He felt it. And I saw it and felt it through him. I mean, I cried at the end of the movie. My brother was crying throughout the movie. We saw years earlier, about decades earlier, this comedy called Navy SEALs, or actually about a decade earlier. Charlie Sheen, Michael Biehn. He was laughing at it. Can you believe that shit? Watching the film over in Westwood Theaters and close to the campus, but not quite. And we're with a sitting in theater with a group of veterans who are watching and laughing at the damn thing. And some assholes are outside making jokes about the damn thing. And my brother gets into a confrontation with them and says they start pushing these buttons. The veterans jumped in and pushed their buttons. The assholes left, and my brother was left talking to the veterans concerning about the movie, pecking at all the wrong parts of the damn thing. So then was a comedy show. It's like watching the comedy movie series of Hot Shots, or Hot Shots What You. He thought it was too damn ridiculous for him to see it, but he'd watch Rambo and then freak out inside. If my brother was still alive and watched the movie Rambo Last Stand, I think he would have had issues with this one as well. We'd watched the original Rambo in the theaters, and my brother was somewhat affected by it because I didn't realize and didn't recognize the PTSD changes in him during that time. Because as a young kid, I'm watching this as a teenager, seeing Sylvester Stallone, and he's suffering through something called PTSD. Goes it over the damn head. Something the Vietnam veterans faced, and it goes in right over my head. Everything about the damn movie was going over my head. All I was thinking was the action and how, what kind of a cruel knife that Stallone was using. It didn't dawn on me what the hell the damn series was about until later on, with my brother and I talked about it decades later. We saw the second movie. The second movie was all right. It was just another action flick. Beefcake, he's beefed up. We kept swearing he was on adrenaline, but Dave says, no, he's not on steroids, John. That's pure muscle. I'm like, shit. The third one comes out, and we're watching this damn shit going on. We're still having enjoyment. He shoved his PTSD down so damn far. He was just enjoying the film. Didn't realize it was also needling his ass. Fourth one came out. I don't think he ever saw that one. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. Maybe I missed it. I swear the Rambo character came back home, or at the end of the film, came back home. But I kept noticing it these days when I was watching it, that Rambo was in his element. He was in the element where he was going through the experiences and the traumatic stuff, because that was home for him for a long while. His other home that he came out of was still there, but the parents are gone, and so was most of the relatives. All that was left was a home left for him, and he stayed in there according to the storylines. and he made a tunnel for himself to live in. A way of coping with what his nightmare was. And I looked at him, and I kept thinking about my own situation. Different forms of PTSD out there, combat, work-related, stress-related, loss-related, life and death injuries. Doctors wondered how come. No, they didn't wonder. Nobody did. Nobody thought I had them. Nobody picked up on the damn thing until my brother was telling me. Several years ago, he had the PTSD, and no other doctor picked up on the damn shit. Because he always knew that there was something different and wrong about me. I had a major accident at a store that damn near killed me, and nobody gave a shit. Changed my attitude, my behavior, everything with me. And I couldn't deal, and I couldn't cope, and it was bad enough Ma died after I had the accident. Everything was changing. My brother was recommended I needed to see a shrink, so I saw a shrink. I saw a shrink. 5 years had to go to the shrink. And I finally got formally diagnosed as having PTSD. And it was regarding loss of Ma. And everything else was leaking out. I didn't realize it until I started doing a hell of a lot of audio taping. I used a cell phone, I used a small portable tape recorder, digital recorder, put it on drives, store them. It's like people writing logs, journals, and keeping them. Don't even go back to them ever again. Because it would hurt like hell to have to listen or see their self. And it would hurt. I've heard them. And my own things I had gone through, and it was just bubbling up like crazy. So over the past couple of years, I really hadn't been treated or talked to by any other healthcare professionals of what's been going on. Past several months because of the COVID shit, and every other kind of emotional shit happening at this point over here. I showed everything else down below, but when I actually need a doctor at this point, everything else is coming back up. People call it white lab coat syndrome. I said, no, that's PTSD because I had it ever since I was 4 years old. I talked about it in many videos. I talked about it in many recordings at this point over here, but I never got into details concerning about my own brother and what hell he was going through. Or seeing how he was going through the shit by seeing other examples of what PTSD was like. Seeing it firsthand. Didn't recognize it. Veterans from World War II. They still suffered through it. Even through the ages of 70s and 80s. I'd seen it in their eyes. I'd seen it in their gaits. And I'd seen it in their walks. And I'd seen it as I was dealing with them. World War I veterans. As a kid, as a teenager, going to a VA hospital to volunteer school credit, just were visiting the veterans and talking with them and befriending them for about a year. A lot of them already gone, dead already. Memories of them still in my head. One or two very vividly. The images. And I did understand it back then. There was no context. There was nothing for me to grasp onto to understand what the hell they were going through. Even if my brother was going through the damn thing, I didn't see it. I didn't recognize it. It was just going over my head completely. But seeing this going on, it rattled my cage. It rattled my cage that I didn't even understand why it was rattled. Until I started getting a handle on it recently. In watching the movie Or actually, last year when I got the series of Rambo from 1 to 4, and I watched all the movies. I could see my brother, and I could also see myself, and also felt myself squirming. Because inside, I was squirming all the shit I was going through, my own personal shit, my own personal PTSD crap, affected me a great deal that I couldn't bear watching the rest of it. Is that because combat I've never been in? Life or death struggle it was. Accidents that damn near took my life. And they stick with you. They stick with you. And it's kind of hard to shove the shit down. Especially when you're permeated with it. I've had nightmares. I've had personality changes, people. But I don't remember any wig outs, and I haven't had any wig outs. But I do know some days I feel depressed as hell. Other days I'm feeling totally angry. Don't even realize why. Somewhere, somehow, there was a trigger done, and then boom. I'm angry. I'm pissed. I want to throttle something or someone. Car screeching. Hear that? My blood pressure's rising at that point. I see ambulances already. My blood pressure rose. Going to a doctor's office, automatic right there for years, for decades. Panic, fear, pain. Some people, they can get used to it. Other people are too damn sensitive about it. I guess I was one of those people that too damn whiny about it, too damn sensitive about it. I wasn't sensitive about seeing my own damn blood. Just too damn sensitive saying I don't want to go through the whole damn bone sticking out of my damn screen. Arms or face smashed in, I could barely see or breathe. By car or by tire falling on the face. And then dealing with people lying through their teeth like crazy, trying to be your friend, but not being a friend. No apologies, just a lot of anger towards you, a lot of resentment. I think I had for a long while a lot of resentment with my brother as well, because it was an accident back in 76, damn it took us out. And I resented the shit out of him for a hell of a long while. He told me that we were going to be safe and I didn't need to wear a seatbelt. I wore a seatbelt and damn near got killed. But if I didn't wear a seatbelt, I would have been killed. My brother gets out. Just looking at an arm, broken wrist. He's barely functioning. It looks like hell. I look worse. I could stay in the hospital for a couple of weeks. Back home. I'm a mummy. I didn't even realize I hated my son, my brother, at that point because he got me into a situation I couldn't forgive him for. He didn't listen. He didn't want to listen. Too much of a rush, too much cocksure about himself. I was too damn scared. Listening to radio rock and roll, trying to relax us both. And he loses concentration and we get into a situation, you know. Go across the, you know, seaside streets, driving a corner, we're just about how many yards away from the damn house? A block? Car spins around, hits oil and water mixture. Ends up in a damn tree. I am dying. David realized. I don't think at that time, or probably other years later on, we've ever discussed it in great detail. Maybe somewhere. I never forgave him for that. I wish I had talked to him about it. I would have forgiven him anyway. I would have told him. That's the hardest damn thing for me to talk about, because it's the hardest damn thing for me to memory and the feelings and the emotions of them, you know. But my brother had been there to get me out of a hell of a lot of shit that I also got myself into. I damn near got killed. And when I had a tire drop in my face at the store, I called my mother. My brother came. He knew the change was happening in me after that point. I already seen, I already knew something about the PTSD, but I really didn't know about it until I was actually taking care of my brother alone and see how the hell he was going through. I already seen how his temper would flare up from time to time, but it just never dawned on me that his PTSD was getting the best of him. He never talked to me about it until the last few years of his life, when he was still alive, when we actually did sat down and talked. And talked in a hell of a lot of talking more about his history. I wish I had a tape recorder at that point. I would have been recording a hell of a lot of information about him. I missed all those damn opportunities. Because it would have given me a hell of a lot more insight into my brother. And what triggered all of this recording and stuff like that, I was watching the movie and I wanted to see it for... I always wanted to see a Rambo Last Stand. I had seen the one prior to that. I already got the Rambo collection I've got with my DVDs somewhere. Boxes of the saga of John Rambo going through PTSD in combat. While he's doing the heroic work, he's also going through the work inside. And the more I studied about the PTSD, even with my own, more and more I got into the character, and more I was trying to understand him. And the more I was trying to help out my brother, I guess more and more I'm relating to what's going on right now as it is. Or what had been for my brother. Because looking at the stance, looking at the structures of the character, looking at the eyes, speech patterns, what he's been going through, trying to live, trying to adjust, and then this hole in the wall down below. His safe zone, the place where he felt more and more comfortable with, because that was in his element. The combat area. Pictures and markings and weaponry and stuff. It was more of him at that point because a lot of him changed. It was always the fact that my brother was always the same way, too. If he had a woman sucking life out of him. His financial life and everything else out of him. Did he love her? I don't know. But I talked about her in different recordings left and right. I should do another recording about her. Just recount and recap the story eventually, but not right now. I had to get this off my chest because this was important to me and probably something needed to be said a long time ago. Because recounting all this stuff is helping me to understand more about me and more about my brother. The older I get, the more I start to appreciate more and more of my brother that I missed, the more I understand him. Examples are one thing, but when the memories come back and I try to analyze them, the more I appreciated my brother. I wish I could have told him I appreciated him a hell of a lot. And this stuff had to talk to me. I had to talk this shit out. I mean, it was hard enough for my brother to do that to a shrink. Even if I wanted to give him medication, it's point over here to help him deal with sleep all the time. I haven't had any nightmares concerning about the tire drops, and man, I still had the anxiety levels, and sometimes I had the dreams concerning about medical. And I would have the experiences of the medical shit happening to me, even as I talk about it. Because I relive it. And it hurts and it scares me and it raises my blood pressure that I can't see the function on some occasions. Don't seem to smile as much. Can't enjoy life as much. I know, people will say, well, try this, try that, try this, be on this regiment, be on that regiment. The only way for me to do it is just to get through the damn shit. Each day is supposed to be a blessing. You're supposed to be accepting it. But each day sometimes is a reminder of what the hell we've gone through and what we survived through. It doesn't matter how many pills you keep pumping into your system, try to elevate or escalate your blood pressure, lower it down. You still have the memories. You still have the nightmares. You still have them back there. You've been through it. You have to walk. People talk about hell while you carry your own hell with you. I guess people don't really understand. I'm watching. And me, after seeing what's going on these days, shit. I'm not quite sure of anything anymore. I will watch the movie a little bit later on tonight, or maybe a little bit later. But I had to get this off my chest. Because I was feeling what I was feeling. And it was flare-ups. I've had grief flare-ups that would drive me crazy. I've had depressional. I've had anxiety. I couldn't even catch my breath half the time. I kept thinking I need to get me a paper bag so I could breathe into it more and more. Just to lower myself down a bit. Even when I'm on a CPAP, forcing oxygen down my throat, I feel like I needed the carbon dioxide more and more sometimes just to relax myself. Because I'd feel the tension, I'd feel the stress, I'd feel everything else popping up in the middle of the night. That's why sometimes I can't sleep, and sometimes I record in the morning at 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning just to tell you what's going on. Because during that time, it would help me focus. It would help me fall asleep. So would a good log report on a damn recorder, but when I try to do it to face myself and face others like this, it's not the easiest damn thing in the world. We've got a lot of issues happening these days. We have a lot of things troubling us these days. We have external things or pushing us to the limit. And maybe even beyond that. And it's hard for us to reconcile it. It's hard for us to deal with it or understand it. Even for me right now as it is. Trying to deal and trying to cope with what's going on right now. And I'm trying to understand it. I'm trying to deal and cope. It's just not that easy. So for the most part, I'm just going to try coping with what's happening. I'll watch the film again, or I'll continue watching it. It's just not that easy because I'm seeing it and I'm feeling it. Maybe it was a mistake, but maybe I'll get the DVD later just to watch it. Because right now I don't think I'd be able to watch that movie. Anything similar to that. It's like watching John Wayne movies now. I can't even deal with them. My brother and I would watch them all the time. Cowboy movies, military movies. And that would be reminding me too much of my brother. Way too much. Anyway. This is one of the things I had to get off my damn chest. So. It's not that easy. It's not that easy coming out and talking about this. It's not that easy to say it out loud. It's not that easy for me to tell people what's going on inside of my head and my heart. Mostly my head. But it's something I had to tell. It's something I had to say. Quite frankly, I don't care if anybody else believes it or not or likes it or not. I don't care. I had to get through it. I had to go through it because it's my own shit. I had to go through my own PTSD, my own hell. I'm not like any other soldier out there. I've got my own versions of the damn thing. It was driving me crazy. Neighbors. Anyway.